Holy crap, Gaijin are not lying. When they say very, very soon, they mean this patch is coming out very, very soon. And especially when Gaijin say it on their Facebook that it's coming out very, very soon, they literally mean it is coming out soon. And usually, leading up to a release of a patch, Gaijin release like 1 to 2 dev blog posts a day. But this is like the sixth or seventh dev blog, excuse me, post of today, and it's to 2 in 1. This is the T-28 and the T-95. Although I would normally do a separate video for each, this one I'm going to do in the same video. This is not only bringing back memories of World of Tanks, it is also bringing back memories of how monstrous this thing is. This is the T-95 and T-28. They both carry the 105 mm gun, which is like, whew. And I mean, look at the long barrel. So I mean, that's gonna just annihilate anything. This is gonna be an awesome thing to get my hands on. Now, I'm not exactly sure what the major differences between the T-28 and T-95 are. Here we have the T-95 and the T-28 here, and you can see that there is definitely a chassis difference here. The T-28 has a flat side, as the T-95 doesn't have that flat side. And it also looks like the T-95 has armored suspension and tracks. And it also looks like the T-28 has this single set of tracks, as the T-95 has a dual set. It is possible that the T-95 is actually like 3 million times bigger because it has the four sets of tracks, as this one only has one. Well, two technically. But you can see the major differences there, and even in the hull chassis thing here. Wow, that 105 mm gun is going to be just absolutely amazing to use. Now, I don't know the armor. Oops, I don't know the armor specs on this thing, but I'm assuming it's going to be. I mean, you hear things, about this vehicle and how everybody wants it in War Thunder, and I don't know if that's because of its real life thing or if that's just because of World of Tanks. But either way, it's obviously got some sort of reputation behind it. And I find a lot of people on my YouTube calling it the Turtle. So I don't know what that means. But when I hear Turtle, I think it's got ma multitudes of armor. So we can scroll down here, and they've actually got a video of it. See, that's the T-28. Actually, this is just the T-28 we're showing. I don't see no T-95, but still. I didn't ask for that. They probably talk about it in here. So I'm not gonna read this. This is for you guys to read if you're interested. Oh, here's the T-95 video. Holy crap! Look at that thing. It's so wide. Uh-oh, I broke it. Oh, it's because it's loading in HD. I'll pause. Oh my god, this thing. Look at this. That's it? That's all it was? Holy crap. Oh. Jeez, what is this, a porn site they posted this on? But no, seriously. Wow, this thing is going to be absolutely deadly. I cannot wait to try and drive this thing. Now, they were saying what tier that these vehicles are being put at, but it doesn't seem like they're posting that here, are they? Oh wow, these crane things on the side are apparently, oops. I've already got that photo up. These crane things here on the side are apparently for resetting the tracks. This thing is massive. Holy crap. I'm trying to see it. It doesn't say, it just says 60 shells available. These vehicles will undoubtedly be a formidable weapon in the hands of more skilled players. Yeah, okay. Oh, right here. Okay. The T-95 and the premium T-28. So the T-28 is going to be a premium vehicle. All right, so at least we've got that out of the way. I'll post that in the title. I'll call it the T-95 and premium T-28. 300 millimeters at the front? What? How are you going to kill this thing? I mean, it's obviously slow, but what are the sides? It doesn't say, does it? It's extremely slow. This tank is achievable or is capable of destroying almost every tank that can stand constant fire from the front. So that pretty much means that Tiger drivers are going to have a hard time with this guy. I don't know what his traverse speed is. They don't post that kind of stuff here. This is the heaviest tank in the game regarding polygon count. I was going to say, because the mouse is the heaviest tank in history. But polygon count, does that mean whenever I drive it, it's going to, cause my game to lag? To the right side of the hall, there are two frame hoists. Yeah, so it doesn't say what tier that this thing is going to be held at. But holy ball wiener, seriously. But it's good to clear that up, and it's also nice to see that the T-95 is going to be in the standard tech tree, as the T-28 is going to be premium, because the T-28 looks like a lesser version of the T-95, but it'll come with the premium bonuses, and I'm sure it has something. I mean, I'm sure it's going to be a little bit quicker and whatnot, but still, holy crap, I cannot wait to drive this thing, and I know a lot of you guys have been dying to get your hands on these, on the T-95 at least. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching and joining me in the next War Thunder upcoming content video.